Now, it's sometimes a little difficult being a proud South Australian. I mean, I love to spruik the joint and stick up for South Australia. I'm heading there this week, actually, for the gather round in the footy. I can't wait to be there. But there's always someone or something making the state of South Australia look, well, making it look a little bit silly.
South Australia has decided to remove all gender-specific terms from state parliament following recommendations to switch language to something that is a bit more gender-neutral.
Terms like he, she, him and her, they have been replaced, as you say, by language that is more gender and sexual neutral, sexual identity neutral, and terms like we have for Her Majesty, referring to the monarch, and also His Excellency, referring to the governor, have now been replaced.
The government says this switch is all about modernising the parliamentary workplace so it's more accessible to more people.
Modernising the workplace. Hey, look, South Australia was one of the first places in the world to recognise women needed the right to vote, and it was the first place in the world where women could vote and stand for parliament. But this toying with the language to neutralise gender, this is nothing to be proud of. In fact, this isn't going to help anyone. It'll make it harder for them to boast about their history. What are they going to say, that they were one of the first places in the world to give the vote to people identifying as humans with vaginas? Now, this is a Labor government doing this in South Australia, as you'd expect. But get this, the Liberals supported it. The Liberal opposition, using that term very loosely, they're on board with this. The whole joint's gone woke. Well, except for a couple of crossbenchers, including One Nation's Sarah Game.
I stand by my comments in the front page Advertiser article that I think this is absolutely ridiculous. The Labor government would do well to focus on greater issues such as child protection and ramping, since the Malinauskas government is now responsible for the worst ramping figures in South Australia's history.
Hear, hear. But look out, this sort of stuff will go national. You know the trend with this sort of stuff. And as usual, there are plenty in the media happy to embrace this virtue signalling, what they see as harmless changes. Journalist Emily Ollie, writing in the Adelaide Advertiser, said that it referred to a professor proclaiming the benefits of gender-inclusive language way back, she said, way back in 2009. Really? Look, there was a great man, I should say a great person identifying as a human with a penis. This person warned all of us about these dangers, the real dangers of manipulating language, 50 years earlier.
As the Newspeak Committee.
Working overtime. It's a beautiful thing, the destruction of words.
Well, the revolution will be complete when the language is perfect.
The secret is to move from translation to direct thought to automatic response. No need for self-discipline.
Yeah, direct thought, automatic response, just manipulate us with the language. George Orwell must be turning in his grave.